What's up, guys? It's Tom again with all of your graphic design resources. If you're a student or a seasoned designer, you're always welcome. So today, designing a t-shirt in Photoshop using your kick-ass designs for a t-shirt. Before we jump right on into this one and the technical aspects of the document when designing a t-shirt in Photoshop, I want to point out quickly that you need to have a printer in mind that suits your designs. This is crucial, and you should shop around for quotes and ask to see some samples first, either in person or online, because you really need to get this part right. The printing side of it is going to be the most crucial, because that is the product you're going to be giving to your customers, your clients, the printed out t-shirt. So you need to get that down perfectly. Just quickly before we set up your document, a quick tip about t-shirt designing is that you should try to keep the detail as less as possible. Of course, some detail is great, but you have to bear in mind the t-shirt needs to be memorable, it needs to be bold, it needs to be something that's not going to have marks or things lost when it's printed because you have too much detail. Also, it's best to use as few colors as possible, so the printing cost is low, and also it looks more bold and it looks more striking and more simple to look at as a design. That appeals more to people. When setting up your document in Photoshop, you want to go to File, New, and you have to keep in mind the dimensions of a t-shirt when setting up your document. So I would suggest something around, I would say 40 by maybe 70 centimeters, and keep the resolution at 300 ppi, and of course CMYK color, cyan, magenta, yellow, black for print. Go ahead and generate that. Going back to the printer and the printing aspect of this, you do need to talk to them as well about maybe having a template for your design, because often if they're exclusively a t-shirt printer, they might have a template for you, a Photoshop file which you just save to your computer, open a Photoshop, and everything is set out perfectly for their specs, for their printing specs. So yes, talk to them, talk to your printer. Very, very important, guys, very important. Your design, you might have designed your illustration in Illustrator or Photoshop or anywhere, but when you bring it in to Photoshop, you don't want this background printing with your design, of course. So first things first is to make a new layer. And to put the opacity right down to zero. You can call it whatever you want, but I'm just going to call it background. Okay. And then this layer here, which is white, which you do not want printing, you can now open up and unlock by double clicking. And then you can delete the layer. So you're left with something like this. This is basically transparent. There's no background here whatsoever. If I go over to my design here, you will see that there's no background. There's just my design here. Now, I designed this shape in Illustrator. It's vectored. And the type was put in Photoshop. Now, you don't want the type to be printed wrongly, you want it printed exactly as you see it on your screen. For the printer to recognize the shape or the font, you need to rasterize the type, so you need to turn it to a shape. And to do that, you select the layers. Rasterize type. Now they're rasterized, you're not going to be able to edit them anymore, so make sure the type is how you want it and says what you want it to say before you rasterize it. Now, once that's done, I like to personally merge all of these layers so it's one layer, as you can see here. When you come to saving and exporting your design for print, there are many different file formats that will work, some better than others, but as I keep going back to and saying and referring to, the printer is king in this process. You need to talk to your printer. They will have their preferred file formats and their settings and everything else, so you really need to get in touch with them. For the purposes of this video, I'm going to show you something a bit unconventional, or at least you might think it's unconventional, but I've exported many designs for print on t-shirts as a PNG file. I know, crazy, PNG. Most people will relate PNG to web-based design, but it does work for t-shirt design. I've used it many, many times. So we're going to line up our design here. I'm going to merge these two layers as well. To export as PNG, you go to File, Export. Don't be hindered by the Save As Web. For t-shirts, it does work. Other files that work are PDF, EPS, and GIF. But for this video, I'm showing you PNG. PNG 24 has more of a large file than PNG 8. And you can check your design here. And you have to have the transparency block checked. Okay, we go ahead and save. And that should be that, guys. That should be your design ready and raring to go for print. Another thing I forgot to mention was color. You're strongly advised to use Pantone colors for your designs, because Pantone color is a list of colors that everyone can type in the code for and they will have that exact color. So there will be no mismatch or confusion printing. If you don't know what Pantone colors are, how to find them or how to use them, in my next video I'm going to go through Pantone colors for you. The last message I have here is that you do talk to your printer, people. Talk to your printer. They're not going to bite, and they will benefit, and so will you, from communication. It will save you time and hassle and money. I cannot stress that enough. If you found this helpful or entertaining, chime in the comments section below. And always remember, create your future today.